there's snow in the forecast. It's 50 degrees out. This guy is lively as could be. He's gathering the last of the heat from this rock he was laying on right here. I believe there's a few rattlesnakes here, but hopefully I don't run across any of them. This guy here is completely harmless. Idaho's an amazing place. Beautiful country. It's just elegant the way it lays, and the scenery is amazing. The peaks and the rolling timber, the meadows, how they all puzzle together to make a beautiful picture. It's just, it's extreme. But the one downside is it's a brutal hunt. I've hunted Idaho everywhere, and it's all straight up and down. It's kind of like the walk to school I had when I was a kid. It was uphill both ways. But in the distance, I've glassed mountain goats on this ridge. On the opposite ridge, on that rock shelf over here, I've glassed bighorn sheep. Just at the foot of the hills where the trees meet tree line, I'm at 9,000 feet right now, and I've got 2,000 to climb, but that's where the elk are here in September. They're up where it's cool, out of the bugs, out of the heat, and away from the hunters. That's where we're headed. I'm sure glad you could join me. Come on, this is gonna be fun.
From the very beginning, man has been a hunter. I too am a hunter, and I have hunted all my life. I gather flesh and bones as my forefathers once had. A journey of pursuing the great beast of the earth. Even so, the chase is hard, for my quarry is keen to the ways of man. And I must hide and wait, taking life and giving back. It's the cycle of life. This is a hunter's journey, a relentless pursuit.
Got him! Bullseye!
These Idaho hills feel steeper than I remember, but the elk are still where I left them, near the top. But the memory of what lies above keeps me pushing further up the mountain. For it's here that the elk live out their September days. Though it's a grind, my past success has fueled my will to climb. Now he's passing above me, just on the edge of my range. If ever I was going to take the shot, the time was now.
Above me about 75, 80 yards. I stopped him with a cow call, held over him about 3.5 feet. Whoop! I got a big one. Yes! Life is good. The marrow of the earth. I'm at the top of the world right now. Yeah. Got me a big bull.
So I'm back with good friends. Randy, he's older than me, and he definitely thinks he's wiser. And Randy's son, Hayden, much younger, and he thinks he's wiser than both of us. Before we hunt, I'm showing Randy just exactly what an elk looks like, so he doesn't shoot the wrong thing.
Service berries.
Service berries.
I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master. And I use Morel Targets, Carbon Express Arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. Advanced Taxidermy brings them to life. I use Muzzy for big fish and wear Mossy Oak Camo. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call, and I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough. It's opening morning, and Randy has set out to kill a bull elk. He knows these mountains like the back of his hand. Meanwhile, I've stayed back near camp, trying to acclimate to the elevation. I'm gathering a little camp meat for the boys when they return from their hunt. Grouse, some of the world's best eating birds. The limit's 5, and that's plenty. The old speed demons are deadly on birds. That's 2 for 2. Takes a little time. If the razor, once it goes in their body, it does the number. Pretty exciting.
I could easily survive with the blowgun in the wilderness. As long as I didn't run out of blowguns. But that's some beautiful birds right there. Got a couple grouse testing out my blowgun here in the wild. And that's three right here at this spot. So about got my limit.
A hunter can't live on grouse alone, you know. Okay, well, maybe you can, but fried squirrel and gravy sure would make surviving much more enjoyable.
The beautiful markings on these squirrels. See the black stripe, big old dark tail. This is a big male. That's a trophy. What works at home in Illinois works here in the mountains. He was clear at the top of the tree, out of my range, but just went under the tree and started calling to him, and he came right down to me. That's a fun way to hunt squirrels. All right, I'm gonna keep moving up through here to see if I can find this.
I continue to call to the squirrel as I step back out of sight. He knows I'm down there, but can't see me, and it's just too much for him to take. He's got to get closer for a better look. The Viper blowgun is the best gun made. It comes with a pistol grip, a polished inside barrel for speed. It's camouflaged and includes deadly hunting darts like the one you see me using. It's a deadly setup.
Bingo! It took a little coaching, but we drew him down the tree. I got him. He saw me coming down the tree. He barked a little bit at me. I wouldn't leave. So he started dropping nuts on me. Some of them actually bounced off my head. Pretty crazy. But in the long run, he got slogged.
In the distance, a bull has answered Randy's call. Of course, it's straight up the mountain as usual. Randy wastes no time in getting closer. After a few cow calls, the bull has responded and is moving into bow range. But the bull turned at the shot. Randy has missed. Looks like we'll be eating squirrel and gravy for dinner tonight. It's kind of sad. Oh well, someone's got to feed us, Randy. You can reach out to Clint Sidney or I on Instagram. Or go to slockmaster.com. There you can find us on Instagram, Facebook, or watch all our YouTube videos. We even got some cool merchandise. Especially if you'd like a spear or blowgun. Meanwhile, we'll look for you in the timber. At last I have arrived. I'm near the top. It's tree line. My cameraman is behind me, breathing heavily. mostly because he's the only one carrying our gear, including my mossy oak camo. During the climb, I've spotted this bull, and he's pushing two cows down the mountain. They're headed my way fast, so I'm moving in for the shot. I have to admit, what you're watching is some of my cameraman's best work. He's captured the bull coming my way as I move into position and prepare for the shot. And like a pro, he is in the perfect position and in perfect focus, capturing what is about to be an over-the-shoulder shot. And then, he happens to glance down and notice that there's a harmless little snake crawling past his boot. And like a little girl, he starts dancing, all the while trying to point the camera my way. Thank goodness for slow motion.
Okay, the first shot was a little off. Pulled back. I let him get too far to the side and I shot through the cedars and nicked the tree, but that Grim Reaper did a number on him. I think I jugglered him. Then he ran downhill and the second shot looked like it was in the breadbasket, so. We waited for 45 minutes. He never ran out across the open, so we're gonna go down where I last seen him. He croaked right underneath that tree, not 70 yards from where I smoked him. The only sad part is I gotta go home. But the good part is I don't have to climb this mean hill again. Tom Klumker, an old buddy of mine, he's 171, probably the oldest man in New Mexico, once told me, he said, "Tim, you do these public land hunts and you do it yourself on your own." He goes, "Get your map out and find the worst place anyone could ever walk to." He said, "That's where the elk will be." And doggone it, Tom, you were right once again. Never knew where I was going, what I was doing. Just picked a spot that was in the middle of nowhere and the longest walk for anyone from all the roads. By golly, there's a dead bull laying right down here. You think I'll find him? Yeah. Aren't they beautiful? You know, every time I hunt elk, it's just amazing to me, the beauty of a bull elk. And I can see why people just, that's one of their bucket lists. You know, every bow hunter wants to kill an elk at some point in their life. And just magnificent beast. God has did some artwork on these guys and he stuck them in the marrow of the earth, man, right up here in the top of the mountains in Idaho. What a beautiful place to die. And today was his day to go to the light. And I'm sure glad I'm the guy that got to send him there. Anyway, I shot him with my Oneida bow and smoked him with a Grim Reaper. You can see I like these three blades. Boy, I use these on whitetails too. And they're deadly, man. That penetration power and then the razor sharp, they just kill animals quick. And that's the objective, just to get them down quick. And from 100 yards, you can see the penetration's just amazing, how well they go in. That there's 25 inches of arrow in that bull, and obviously from that angle, it's through the heart and stuck in the opposite shoulder. So that thing had to travel through a lot of the carcass before it stopped. You know, another thing, I wish I would have brought two Matias. I only brought one Matia to film me and carry my elk out. But if I'd have brought two, then I wouldn't have to carry so much meat. So I better stop talking and start cutting and packing. So glad you got to come with us today. And like I said, I hope you enjoyed it. And I know I sure did. And now the fun's over and the work begins. So.